We are heading into the actually second semi-finals match today and of the entire tournament, I think. The matchup is Mego against Lucas, France against China, Teal against Green. And getting that Makagi and idling his monk, it's a huge mistake because he has to get the goats in the middle. And was it a wood start? Looks like it because Mego is towing down a trading post. First two goats go to Mego, and the scout is looking for the other ones. And aha, he's not running in the middle with the scout because obviously he also wants to get a TP. Finds another goat, so it's three goats to two right now, and he's also gonna find the ones that are over here, most likely. No. Okay, this is what happened. Lucas already found them with his disciple. Gonna scout around the bottom of the map. 80 food is in the middle, and there are some rather mediocre treasures, except for this one. And that usually means that there are beefy treasures up south, and that's exactly what's happening. Unfortunately, Mego was chopping quite aggressively for his house, so this 80 wood treasure doesn't, or 85 wood, doesn't help him in his age of time anymore. And this is, I've seen Maito do quite a bit in his streams, or also recorded games. He delays chopping wood as much as possible in the hopes of finding such a beefy treasure and then getting a better H1 out of it. This goat in light of sight of Mego, gonna come back for it later. He has 5 goats to 3, and there are 2 more to be picked up. Probably what you expect. France has a better scouting game than China. Ever so slightly, so he's gonna get more goats. 40 wood gonna go into the coffers of Lucas as well, not speeding up his village. Kinda to be expected since it was quite late and the shipment is in already. I'm not gonna show the shipment tab, you guys can guess what was sent. Actually, it's showing up right now. I was a little bit early on that one. Lucas heading toward the 80 food treasure. Mego should be aware of this. He has seen the Chinese monk, and I think he also got punched a bit by Tian Yuan. Gäsach Klein, okay. That was Turk, who had all his guys named Sexy. And Lucas is now going for the 80 food treasure. Mego notices it. Yeah, he's gonna be in time. It's gonna be a treasure contention. Let's have a look. And I think Mego got it. He was like, actually Lucas got it. He was like, faking shooting the leopard, but then cancelled it last minute to throw Lucas off. But nevertheless, Lucas gets it, and now he has the snare and is expertly using his disciple to block the explorer. But then again, an expert pull coming in from Maito, saving his explorer, which is of course nice since you want that scouting information. 30 coin, gonna get picked up, and 40 CDB age up, and Mego again being delayed. Behind, he is only aging up like at 310, and if you do good macro, who gets this one? Again, Luca. So his treasure game is quite good. And nevertheless, he is only clicking up right now. 330 is late by usual civ standards. It's kind of normal for China, but it's still slow, and so he has to put 4 villagers on the wonder since he wants to be up in time. Since if you age too slowly as China, you can get punished by some aggressive stuff, since you can't really respond to early military units in France. Has some decent options to pressure slightly early on. But yeah, Mego again aging late, because Miss Macro maybe not hurting the Gaja goats as the big G intended. You can see 2 of them over here, and the other one slaying down over here. So not too pleased. Garja is gonna be with his herding. That sounded like quite Yoda-esque, this phrase. More treasuring going on, not really much scouting because there's nothing to scout. The HOP is always the same. What is this? Why are there 4 CDBs running into the middle of the map? Like, usually you send at max 2 forward. Gonna get this treasure. Is he gonna get snared? Yes, he is. Does get the HOP HP, but still gonna get destroyed. Freitag. Doing more scouting. Where's the other Freitag? Is he dead already? Why does nothing happen when I click on these? I don't understand. Ah yeah, Freitag is over here, the other guy. Lucas scouting, of course. He has to scout a little bit more. And the shipment sent were, of course, the villagers. And the critical thing is going to be, what is Lucas' first shipment going to be? If it is anything other than 700 coin, we're going to see some colonial action. And if not, then it's going to be an FF. And can he save the scout? Most likely he will be able to. I wanted to say that 4 CDB is pretty much a no-brainer out of France. Or it's pretty much the strongest option. But he does send 700 wood. And I have no clue why. He does have forward barracks. Let's have a look at the units in queue. Is this going to be some pikemen? No, some crossbowmen actually. And he already has some pikemen. Oh no, he has already some bowmen over here. Not sure what he intends to do with these. He can't really siege the TP down. The nice thing with this kind of style is that you can get 5 pikes pretty early and just siege down the China TP. And there's not really much the China player can do about it if he doesn't want to completely ruin his build order. So that's like a pretty good window you have as France. Mega not using it this time. We did see it the last game, but probably wants to do something different right now. Wow, and now shipping 700 coin and not shipping 4 CDB at all. This indicates to me that he's extremely all in H2. He's just shipping crates and trying to make a big timing happen before Lucas is able to age up, or right as Lucas is about to age up. And Lucas is aging with the porcelain tower, so there's not going to be a big skirmisher mess out right away. Which makes the crossbowmen from Migo a little bit more comfortable. Pumping out those units, musketeers out, cavalry out, but he's only sieging the Summer Palace, and it's like Lucas doesn't really care about this. Even if this thing goes down, if he goes up to Fortress unscathed and France has no follow-up, he's probably ahead. Now the monk is gonna tank some. Minutemen coming out, the second Minutemen also gonna come out. Looks like no, but this just seems kinda wasted, this pressure. I don't think he's getting much done at all. Lucas is using his TC perfectly, only has 8 villagers in the TC because that's the number you need to 3-shot a musketeer. He should have one more in there so that he would be a little bit more efficient, but doesn't really matter here. Now the territorial army, or the standard army, old army, it's something called, comes out, managed to fend off the Summer Palace, and like this siege damage means nothing. His palace is never gonna go down now. There's a shipment on the way for Lucas, he's in the fortress age, he has much more economy. He still has some hunts in his base, actually plenty of hunts, and he's completely fine here. Just needs his shipment, and then he still has some Minutemen available. Needs to be careful with these villagers, doesn't want to lose them. Oh, this one barely gonna go down, quite close. Still some pressure from Migo. But he did get 2 villagers, which is good, of course. Intervention now coming out, which is basically perfect against Muskars. Luckily, Migo does have some crossbowmen, or not luckily, he made them by conscious choice. But I still think that Lucas is okay here. Yeah, this is super aggressive for Migo. He never shipped 4 CDB, 700 wood, 700 coin, and then military shipments. The bowmen are now in the fray, pressuring the base, and China does need a little bit of time to get out the mass in H3, but when they do, it's scary. And now there are meteor hammers out, and Migo does have a lot of map control and pressure. But Lucas still has some guys in his base, some resources in his base, and also these goats are starting to fatten. He only has 3 of them, but that's still 900 food, and that's like the crucial amount of food that you need to hold in these kinds of situations. Like having 900 food available and not having it can make or break a game. Migo, of course, still being ahead because of his aggressive build order, but the units are, of course, more technologically advanced for for Lucas here. There's a big fight happening. Not sure why Lucas committed to this this early. Might have wanted to wait for another shipment, but it actually looks like he is getting cleaned up. Wow. Yeah, there are no more anti-cav left over. His Arquebusier is desperately running back. There's still a decent army left over for Migo, and now he's gonna be able to idle Lucas forever. Forever, ever? Forever, ever. Last skirmisher is gonna go down. These coin mine villagers are gonna get denied. Of course, China can always hide and lame and idle with their villages. But if you don't have any military, you're not gonna gather ever again. More bowmen coming out. And yes, Migo didn't ship for CDB, but the French economy is still okay. So he's still able to mass up units behind this, and now just some Zhengdao coming out. And if Migo scouts this, he's just gonna do some nice micro with his Hus and just kill them completely. So the eco is actually now ahead for Lucas, for Migo. Since he did lose some villagers, and I bet he idled his DC. Like, if you're gonna look at the postgame graph later, they're gonna be more villagers going down, so actually now decisively ahead in economy. And wow, and now also ships for CDB, so getting even more ahead in economy. And what an interesting build order for Migo. This is completely non-standard. You never see this, basically. People always ship for CDB kind of early. And it just, he just had such a big mass all the time, and Lucas committed to a fight that he maybe didn't need to commit to. Not completely sure about that. And now the TP is gonna go down, so the shipment spam is gonna be slower. And yeah, I do have the recalc population on. I still don't understand why he sent 4 CDB, but it doesn't really matter right now. He's in a good position, I think. Score is also ahead by 20 points. Of course, China's usually slightly behind on score. But okay, now it's 30 score. So it's he's definitely ahead. This guy also lying dead on the floor, not going to be able to tank anything. And this is a problem with the China army. You just don't get the units that you want sometimes. He has a lot of Zhengdao, but he really wants a more balanced composition, but can't really do that. He needs two shipments for that, and his reinforcements are also going to be balanced out, so he can't really reinforce with one unit specifically. And now these Hussars are going to do a number on the skirmishers. These Zhengdao are a little bit out of position, also getting sniped on by the crossbowmen. Now a lot of Hussars everywhere, basically. There are still some musketeers, I think. Not that many musketeers, actually, so these Cav are doing quite well. But as soon as the Zhengdao are down, the Hussars are going to be able to fight the Cav and fight the Arquebusiers. And actually, it's going kind of okay for Lucas. He's getting some decent trades, I feel. But more musketeers coming in, and only a 3 Hussar badge, but it's probably enough. That's all he needs. And yeah, this is what happens as China. You just get Hussars against skirmishers sometimes because of the way the unit badges training system works. And now all these skirmishers are pretty much toast. Migo pulling ahead more in economy and gonna clean up his opponent again. And after this, he is definitely win. Like, I don't think there's much Lucas can do at this point. He does have a shipment ready, more units popping out, but with good micro and control, there's still some Zhengdao. They're getting sniped down now. And now there's no military whatsoever left for Lucas. Luckily, he was able to sneak out some villagers over here, which is good. Obviously, it's good if you have villagers gathering. And this guy is scouting over here, sees immediately that Lucas is heading out. Sieging the village is not really that much worth that much, since Lucas doesn't have any population anyways. But it doesn't really matter. Might as well just get something done with the villagers. And where's the Nat Scout actually? It's nowhere to be seen. Probably it died again. Sad life. Because if the Nat Scout was around, this would be much easier to spot, and that would be basically GG if that gets spotted. Like, as soon as a Hussar enters the line of sight radius of this, Lucas is gonna resign. That's how big that is. More Hussars coming in. That's exactly the unit he needs to reinforce. He has enough infantry to snipe anything, and Hussars are what makes the fight happen, so that's what he wants right now. He has also upgraded them with Cav HP and shipping more crate shipments, and getting actually having double the score of his opponent. So now Lucas is gonna do some turking. Everybody does some turking. Someone Someone needs to make a meme on Isak about that. And now, yeah, it's gonna get spotted and probably on the minimap in the Megabot saw that there were dead animals just sieging the village for dominance. Not even killing the villagers, just taunting his opponent to resign. Redcoats coming out, but they are no match for so many units, and these villagers are all gonna die now. And oh, that's why Lucas wasn't resigning. He has mantras on the way. I completely missed that. And these mantras are super strong, especially in a stationary position like that. They do very well and do very good DPS. But unfortunately, there's still some bowmen in the mix, and they do double damage against cavalry. So, and the musketeers, once they get in melee, is also not so good for the mantras. And yeah, unfortunately, still getting cleaned up. But that was his. That was the last hurrah from Lucas. Nice Manchu pop, unfortunately too little too late. Let's have a look at the resources gathered, and France actually never behind. Quite interesting, and yep. If you look at this, quite a lot of idling was done. Essentially he never trained a villager after he hit Fortress. And Mega of course kept doing that, and he got some good fights. Like this fight, maybe Lucas could have delayed that a little bit more, wait for another shipment, for some more techie units. And then he gets cleaned up again, and after that it's basically over. So, really interesting build coming from Migo. He has some interesting France strats, obviously, first doing the Grenadiers, which didn't work that well, but this one was definitely good. And it was, there's no excuses, basically. It was against the straight China FF, and he won. He did good pressure, he did clean up the army, and clean up the army again, and yeah, just good execution for Migo, and he is at 1-0 now. I'm pretty impressed by that. Huh. Astounding. Let's get out of this one. And I kind of want to formulate a thought, but I can't really do it. The thing is, if you go colonial as France, you have a big mass against a tiny mass of Chinese units. And as long as the China mass is small, it's easy to micro against it. And so that might be like a hidden strength of this H2 build, that you have just so many units and can micro them really well, so you're basically maybe guaranteed to get a good trade. And that's what... that's what makes it strong. Maybe Migo restarting because of Soundpark. Maybe getting no. IP check. No. That's why I'm stupid actually. I added Migo's account, Migo, and not IndiaBot. So that's why I was seeing him offline all the time. Confusing times, yeah. Yeah, the players looks like they're discussing the post game. Lucas not sure what he did wrong. Okay, Migo saying that he likes this build order quite a lot, that he did. And Lucas feels like he did nothing really wrong. And
yeah.
Lucas not sure what he did wrong. Ah, yes, colonial militia might definitely be a play against this. Lucas saying it's only good against Expo. Muska still is two shot, but one shotting Expo is still good. Yeah. Yeah, Migos was very aggro. it's quite interesting to see the players discuss this game afterwards. Unfortunately, they are doing it in German, so I have to translate. But basically, Lucas not sure what he did wrong, and Migo saying he liked this BO for quite a while, and he's very aggressive because the 4CDB are very late. And Lucas, I suggested that he maybe waits longer for the fight, but then he says he gets only idled longer, which is of course true. He was getting pressured by quite a lot, and yeah, maybe this is a meta-defining game for this matchup, because the build order from Migo seemed quite strong, and I don't really know what you could have done much better. As Lucas, obviously you can always do some tiny control things better, but probably against this you actually have to go H2, or H2 would have definitely been another option. Since H2 China is potent in the beginning, at least. Now the second map is Baja California, and this is actually the same map pool for all round of 8 matches, quarterfinals matches. No, this is the quarterfinals. I'm getting confused again. So we're gonna see Baja California and then Guatemala again. And I hope everybody's impressed with my Spanish pronunciation of these names of the maps. Okay, looks like Migo's gonna lock Iroquois. I still haven't figured out the Sifu is completely yet. Can Lucas counterpick with China? Or can he not? Looks like he's considering it, at least. Ah, and of course Maito suggesting in the chat that the Skirm age up would be something to do against that aggro French H2, because then you get a quicker mass up, and then you ship the red codes, and with the half minutes, you're probably fine with good control against the Hussar mass. And yeah, that is what Lucas could have maybe done differently. Or if it would have been better, I don't know. But that's definitely an option that he had available to him. He didn't need to age with the Porcelain Tower. Okay, we have Iroquois against Sioux, and Sioux is an interesting civ. It was considered kind of broken on RE. Like, not really too strong, but just kind of broken in a one-dimensional sense of the civ, if that makes any sense at all. And then it was bad on AP, and then it was good on AP, and then it was got nerfed again, and then it was bad, and now it's kind of somewhere in the middle. People are saying it's actually quite decent. I think it does have the 5 villager shipment again. It had like 4 villagers, and 5 villagers, and 4 villagers, and now again 5 villager shipments. And also the big button is strong, and you can get nice age up bony. You don't have to build houses, so stagecoach TP is a little bit easier to do. You only start with 5 villagers, which is unfortunate, but that's what happens. You have the strong Warchief Explorer. And yeah, Sue's a pretty decent Sith. And Lucas also known for playing Sue. So this is game number 2. Migo against Lucas. If you can't figure out who Migo is, process of elimination. It was a missed crate start again. I don't think I have seen a single crate start today. Picking up a small coin treasure, and looks like it was a wood start, maybe, or maybe not. But Migo is definitely chopping a lot of wood, and looks to me like he's posturing to get this trading post, potentially. No big treasures have been picked up yet, but a lot of them have been scouted so far. This one is decent, 70 XP, 75 coin, kinda bad, 60 food, 40 coin. This one is huge for any hero that can get it. And this one is also big, and I think he's gonna find it. No turning back, that's unfortunate. The Trovoir is still running around, it's a converted Puma, and yeah, Migo is going for that early TP. Did Sue get 100 wood removed from the starting gates, or do they just... Nah, they don't have 100 wood, and because they don't need a house, obviously, so he just decided to put down 2 TPs. And Don't shout at me if I'm wrong, but I think a TP increases the gather rate by 8%. And they do not stack or multiply or anything with each other. So he just built two because then he gets more radius out of it. That is how it is, I think. And now getting 30% HP, and someone has scouted this. I think it was the Trovoar from Migo, which is now over here in a house, leading a happy life as a house. Needs to get a partner soon, though. Small coin treasures getting picked up. Let's have a look at the shipment sent. Not like there's going to be anything groundbreaking there, since the shipments are not in already. Three villagers here and three villagers there. 60 food. Is he going to pick that up? I hope so, since it's going to help him age up quicker. And while we are... Oh, well, we actually don't have downtime. There's a treasure contention going on, and looks like Migo is just scared. Runs and runs away. Because, of course, this is a little honcho. Lucas running away now. And Migo going back in to deny any potential, to be able to contest the treasure, basically. And now it looks like Lucas is comfortable going for this treasure if he converts one and kills one, or actually can kill both pretty quickly. It's not gonna help up his age up that much anymore. He's again kind of late. Or like, usually you wanna click up at before 3 minutes, and Lucas is only clicking up to us now. Maybe that is also the nature of the sieve. I'm not quite sure about that. That the macro is just harder, and so he ages up a little bit later. But the king of late age ups, Migo, today aging at 3:30 with the Iroquois, and that is due to, of course, him chopping a lot for his TP. Nothing really wrong with that. Getting the TP in is still okay, and then aging up later. So he had a 16 villager age up. Of course not ideal, but he did get that early trading post. And so while we're heading up to the Colonial Age, we can discuss how the matchup usually goes. It looks like Lucas is going down for this 120 XP treasure, which is going to mitigate the trading post a little bit. I think Iroquois can go quite aggressive in this matchup, or at least go mid-map and take map control, because they tend to scale better in the late Colonial Age, because they have beefy infantry unit upgrades. And so Sue eventually wants to go up to the Fortress Age. Does Lucas have that crazy convert card in his deck? No, he doesn't. I'm pretty sure it is in H2 that you have a card that converts all X-Riders to Rifle Riders. But he doesn't have it in deck, which might be something to do against musketeers and cavalry, but since the Aena is so strong for Iroquois, chooses to not have it in his deck. Aging up with 400 wood, also getting a TP in transition, probably gonna get a market as well. Iroquois also has a market, and placing actually the most defensive warhead I've ever seen in my entire life. Aging up with Wise Woman, and yeah, so with 400 wood. And actually, Luke is going to be aggressive here. And building a warhead immediately gets scouted, so maybe that's why Migo was kind of defensive. The eco of these sieves is pretty comparable, since it's basically the same. Only the TPs are maybe giving Sue a slight edge, and also if they can't get that Wise Woman age up with the 20% gather rate boost and the Bisons, then the Sue eco is actually better, but the Iroquois units are better. So that's kind of the trade-off between these civilizations. Lucas choosing to take map control with this very stylish-looking warhead. Constructing a second trading post, and maybe has clubs in the queue. No, seated in the queue. Maybe we could have done clubs to siege the TP and get the sage good, but probably not wise against Iroquois, because they can be so aggressive if they want to. Shipping 700... wood. This must be for seed and production. Like, yes, and club production, and probably also gonna get a stable. Come on, put it down. You know what you wanted. Migo being greedy, first shipment, 5 villagers, and now 7 Aena, because he feels that the pressure is coming. Crackshot is gonna kill 2, basically 2 seed. And they are slower than the Aena. But they do make they do have stronger arm muscles because they do more damage. So they are better firing the bow. And now the clubs are coming out and they're going straight to siege this town. And they have basically the siege of seven pikemen. Slightly less. Doesn't really matter. And Lucas is just posturing in the middle of the map. He does have map control and a potential stagecoach, but he is behind in economy so far, and also Mego is doing a basically straight FF. He only shipped the seven Aena, which I don't understand why he did that. Maybe he was expecting more pressure, and then after there was not really pressure coming in, he just decided, okay, let's age. But you can also train these Aena. They are very efficient. They only cost 100 food. That's basically the best cost for a unit that you can have. So you just can train Aena and make Tomahawk Big Button and just ship 800 resources, which would give you slightly more resources over the long run, but this is a safer play, so completely acceptable. Especially since Lucas was posturing quite aggressively. Also now getting 4 X-Rider, that's an insane shipment for H2 standards. It's basically 800 resources in military units. And right as he ages up, the push comes in. Maybe could have gone in a little bit sooner, but it's of course difficult since he also wanted to get that TP down. Now a big brawl gonna happen. Is the Tomahawk Big Button on the way? I don't know, it's not in units in queue. But this, it is looking grim. Some of the Aenas are in melee, that's not good. The clubs are coming in, snaring everything. The Warchief is going down now, so no more HP boost and also XP boost for Lucas. All the X-Riders are down. Kania's getting shipped now. Can he snipe down the last clubs? There are still two or three left. Difficult to see, but all the clubs are down now. And I think he has done it. I don't think. Yeah, this is it. The 6 Aena shipment, also, of course, quite strong. Cleans up everything, and that's quite unfortunate for Lucas because he has just shipped the 4 or 5 villagers that wanted to get into the fight. Slightly misrallied. And now he has no unit no units and has just decided to go more greedy while he just got cleaned up, which is unfortunate. Are these getting teched now? No, doesn't really need it now. The forest growlers coming in, as I like to call them, and the Warhard is pretty much toast at this point. These clubs can't do much. No stagecoach. Oh, actually, stagecoach. Just as I was said, no stagecoach. Stagecoach comes in. So that's where some of Lucas' resources went. Unfortunately, if Mego is paying attention, which he most likely is getting siege down right away. It's getting spotted right away, and he's gonna be able to siege down this TP and get himself 2 TPs, and then after that, pressure the base, and this is pretty much looking over for Mego. It's looking over for Lucas, and Amigo's about to make it over. Only hunting dogs, no steel placer mines. Lucas does have steel placer mines. Why do we want to say steel preps all the time? This TP is not really a factor, so not getting siege down. 5 canyons coming in. Are they now elite? Nope. Doesn't have the resources for it yet. This guy is unfortunately lying dead in his opponent's base. Not really much to say about this one. Lucas is also running out of resources. Kind of not really. He has a hunt over here. And some nice berry bushes over there. Feeling actually pressured enough to go onto these. And he's most likely gonna resign. Once these villagers get cleaned up. And these have to run north, which is not ideal because when they get spotted, they will die. Now the eco pop is even, and Lucas is actually aging right now, but he is aging slow. No, the messenger. So he is aging fast. Unfortunately, he's getting pressured right as he clicked up. That's basically the perfect time to pressure someone when he just clicked up. So you have basically the most time in the world to make use of this window of opportunity. And yeah, Lucas has to resign after that. So that's GG, well played. And this Man, I'm so confused. This was the last series of the day, right? Yeah, it's kind of late already. Quite an even game. Unfortunately, this fight just went very poorly for Lucas, and after that, there's not much he can do. H2 Su is not the greatest, and if you get cleaned up against H3 Iroh, it's pretty much over.